Hey guys, what is going on? Eric Fairwell from Aviator Paramotor here once again with another episode of Paramotor Tech Talk, the Thursday show that teaches you how you can repair your paramotor. Alex today is going to be breaking down our very first Vitarazzi Moster. This engine used to be mine. I flew it for 3 hours, sold it to our student John, who then over the last 2 years has flown over 350 hours on it. He recently traded it in for a new one, but we thought, you know what? This looks like a perfect opportunity to break the motor down, do a full top-end rebuild, take a look at the internals, and see if it needs any major maintenance help. So we bought all the new parts, laid things out, and Alex is gonna break this motor down and put it all back together for you, showing you every single detail of what you need to do to be able to replace the top end on your paramotor. One of the cool things for us on this is that we're actually gonna sell this engine at the end of the show, so stand by for that. If you're looking for a used Moster, we've got one now. Have a great day, guys. Alex, take it away.
Welcome to another edition of Paramotor Tech Talk. Today we're going to be doing a top-end rebuild in a Moster 185. We're going to basically be removing the head, the cylinder, and the piston, replacing the piston, the cylinder, and all the gaskets and related items. For this project today, we're going to need a small screwdriver, a regular flat screwdriver, some crush thread checker. We're going to need an Allen wrench for the head. We're going to need some wire cutters, extensions, variety of extensions. We're going to need a spark plug socket. We're going to need a 30 millimeter socket, a 30 millimeter wrench, and a torque wrench. To gain access to the head, we must first remove the spark plug and the heating shroud. Please retain all the hardware to be reused. Next, remove the standoff nuts for the head. Now all the nuts and the standoffs are removed. Now you can actually try to work the head out. Make sure you save those washers and inspect for conditions of the head. Looks pretty clean. Next, remove the exhaust so you can actually gain access and remove the cylinder from the engine case. With the exhaust removed, now you can have access to your cylinder and remove it. Sometimes you might have to tap it a little bit. Make sure you use a mallet hammer and gently tap it to get it out of the seat. As we can see, this particular cylinder is in very good shape for 350 hours. It's actually in excellent shape. Next, we're removing the piston by removing the circlip around the wristband. With the circlip removed, now you can move around the piston and remove the wrist pin to get out of the connecting rod. With the cylinder and piston removed, now you can inspect the area of the engine for any kind of debris, as well as cleaning the base gasket area to get it ready for the new gasket. You can also inspect your wrist pin bearing by inserting the brand new wrist pin on it and check it for excessive play or movement. This one seems to be perfect. 350 hours, that's fantastic. Before we begin the reassemble, we're going to install the piston rings into the pistons. Please notice that these piston rings are offset just for the gap and have these little bitty pins on it. That's where the gap goes. So basically, start inserting your piston ring as such. Expand it so you don't damage the cylinder wall or the piston walls, and clog them in that direction. Make sure that the rings flow freely around the pistons as such, and that you can get a good grip all the way around the edge So it will be, so we positively seal into the chamber. Now we are ready to reassemble the piston assembly and all the related parts. Before we begin, make sure that you locate these two ports the same way you take them out. In this case, they are facing my way. Another tip that I like to do is I like to reassemble the wrist pin circlip in one side prior to begin my assembly. That makes it easier to insert the wrist pin on it as you are assembling the bearing and the connect and the piston into the connecting rod. To begin the assembly, I like to use two cycle oil for assembly oil. All the metal to metal surface, it will be a very, very good idea if you coat them, every single one of them. I begin by coating the bearing. I grab my wrist pin and I get it started on my piston. I insert the bearing into the connecting rod and press through it all the way down. Now we're getting ready to install the circlip on the wrist pin inside the piston. There's a little groove that goes all the way around. Please make sure that this particular circlip is sit all the way around that groove. If this come off, it will cause an engine failure, possible engine failure. There you go. Next, I move the piston all the way down. Make sure the skirt does not hit the edge of the case. That will allow easy installation of the cylinder head. Next step, with the area cleaned up, install the base gasket. Next, you install your cylinder. Prior to installing your cylinder, make sure you coat your piston with some oil. You don't want any metal to metal contact. So as your cylinder, make sure you cover the walls very well. You may encounter a little bit of smoke at the first startup, but it's better a little bit of smoke than metal to metal contact. Insert your cylinder. You can compress your rings. Make sure you find that little dowel. You can compress them, move them a little bit, wiggling around. The first ring is in. Move to the second ring. It's clocked about another 30 degrees off from that one. Got both of them compressed and installed. And now the cylinder is seated. The next step of the process is installing your cylinder head. Make sure your cylinder head is cleaned up. The area where the cylinder head gasket goes is so clean and free of debris and no damage. Install your cylinder head gasket and very carefully fit it through the studs and seat it in place. The last step of the process of this particular process is installing these washers and the cylinder head nuts and then torque them. Make sure you follow the torque spec from the factory specification sheet, section A for the actual Vitorassi manual for the Monster 185. Make sure you cross torque these bolts and check them all the way around. Followed by your spark plug. And the rest of the accessories, such as the heat shroud and the muffler. That was the Monster 185 top end rebuild. Just remember to actually break it in after the job is completed by the manufacturer specifications. And for more information in these parts and where to get them, please go to aviatorppg.com store. Thank you for watching.